Hi, I'm Dan Millen with Livernois Motorsports. Thanks for watching our videos. So today we've got our 2021 Durango Hellcat here, and we've done videos in the past on this, and we've done just a tune only, but now we spent a little more time on this, and we've put our S1025 package on this. So if you are familiar with our S1025 package, we do a lot of those on different applications. One, which is similar to this, is the Trackhawk. S1025 is basically 1,025 horsepower at the engine. You know, a little bit probably in the 800 to 900-ish range at the tires being all-wheel drive when it's all said and done on E85. So the 1025 package is complete flex fuel. We were first to market on the Trackhawk with flex fuel. We're first to market with flex fuel on the Durango here. So we went ahead and we put our package on it. The 1025 really is upper, lower pulley, a set of injectors, some really aggressive and good tuning, and our cold air kit. So we're gonna go ahead and run this thing first on 93 octane. We're gonna get our numbers, we'll show you what that is. And then we're gonna go ahead and drain the fuel out, put in straight E85 using the same tune and calibration. It's a flex fuel calibration, so it'll learn the ethanol content, and we'll run it again on E85, and we'll show you the results on both those. So stay tuned and thanks for watching. Okay, so we ran this truck 93 octane, and it was very impressive. Probably one of the more impressive 93 octane tunes we've done on the Trackhawk Hellcat style engine. So anyway, we look right here. Baseline, this truck when it was stock, because we did run this thing stock before, we were 577, and we're almost up 200 horsepower on this thing on a 93 octane tune on the S1025 package. So really impressive. Not quite 200 foot-pounds, closer to like maybe 180 foot-pounds better. So really, really impressive. Something that I think someone would appreciate, a 93 octane. Anyway, we're gonna drain the gas out of this thing, fill it up with E85, and we're gonna do some more runs on this thing and get the final pull on E85 and what kind of power increase it is. But anyway, for so far, the Durango is a very, very impressive truck, just like the Trackhawk. We pretty much figured we'd see the same results, same drivetrain, same engine, very, very similar calibration. So stay tuned here, we're gonna do the E85. Okay, so you've seen we just ran this thing with E85. Really impressive, kind of exceeded my expectations. This thing is up, let's take a look at the graph right here. So we're up, we'll just call it peak to peak, over 300 horsepower and definitely over 200 foot-pounds, closer to 230. Super impressive. Probably, like I said, this is one of the better ones that I've seen. We had some Trackhawks that have done just about 900 with the 1025 package, so this thing's very impressive. So we are really excited to share this with the community, and we're going to be doing these tunes remotely for people. Or if you want to call up Livernois Motorsport and get the package here, we'll do that for you. So anyway, a super impressive. I think it's very safe and a very good calibration in this thing. It's obviously one of the first ones we've done with the 1025, but again, it's a very proven package, proven calibration in the Trackhawk, same stuff here. A little bit more impressive than normal. Usually when you go from gasoline to E85, it's about a 10% increase in power. This is a little bit more, and I can explain that. The reason why is it's a little bit richer on 93 than most people would like to see it, but it's to save the vehicle, save the engine. It's the right thing to do. And with E85, we're allowed to put a little bit more timing in it, lean on it a little bit harder. So kind of expected results, but a little bit overachieving. So anyway, stay tuned for more stuff to come on the Trackhawk, or excuse me, on the Durango Hellcat, and look forward to some more stuff. Thanks for watching.